Good evening, everybody. I'd like to welcome all the families, teachers, the staff, and the sixth graders. Tonight, we will continue a long-standing Hadley tradition of celebrating the sixth grade class as they move forward in their academic careers. Tonight, let us acknowledge and honor how much they have grown and learned. We look forward to their bright futures ahead of them. I present to you the class of 2024.
Too easy.
I remember in first grade when I heard the fire alarm and I grabbed the ruler.
fourth grade dressing up as Bernie Sanders for a project. I remember in kindergarten when I jumped in the recycling bin because I heard the fire alarm.
I remember in fourth grade when Fitzy, Yuki, and I hid in our lockers. I remember in fourth grade when Cooper, Yuki, and I wore shirt stoppers for the whole entire year. I remember in fourth grade when... Oh.
I remember in fifth grade when Mr. C beat Eric in basketball.
I remember in preschool when Fitzy, Hunter, and I wanted to be woodchip mommy, so we buried ourselves in woodchip. I remember in first grade when Hannah and I draped it before I became a thousand grape soda.
I remember in sixth grade when some girls chased my kite at recess because they thought it was sacred.
I remember in fifth grade when I won the
JOB. I remember in fifth
grade
when I found
Tessa. I remember the Greek Olympics with Mr. Driver.
I remember in fourth grade at the concert when my trombone
played
well,
but
they started laughing really hard.
I remember in sixth grade when I came here.
I remember in fourth grade when someone squirted a go-gurt on my nose.
I remember in fifth grade when Mr. Driver and I got into a big fight and we started throwing markers at each other.
I remember in sixth grade when Mr. C beat his finger.
I remember in third grade when Ms. Barrett played Candy Crush with a real hammer and candy and yelled, 3-0!
I remember in fourth grade when the tectonic plates of crackers and chocolate frosting.
I thought if you got a question wrong on a test, you had to go to the principal's.
I remember in fourth grade when my dad stepped in Alamo.
I remember in kindergarten coming to class. There was only me and one other student there for the entire day.
Much more, including teaching the whole school music every day
and taking her own time to come here every Tuesday to teach chorus. On behalf of the graduating sixth grade class, we thank her and would like her to know we will miss you. Thank you so much, Ms. Brain.
It takes a lot to run a school, and we have been lucky to have some great administrators who have helped us along the way. We would like to take this time to thank Dr. Whitman, who's been there to guide us the past 2 years. We appreciate you looking out for us and taking care of us. Ladies and gentlemen, our principal, Dr. Joan Whitman.
Well, it's hard to follow that introduction. Elliot does a great job of that. So there's been a little kind of hiccup in our program early on. Well, my prepared statement has already been delivered. So I'm going to speak from the heart, but just for a minute, because I know we have a lot to share this evening. So this class will be my last class that I graduate, because I too am moving on. But I have to say, I couldn't be going out on a better note. This has been an awesome class. And you know that as parents, you have the pleasure of having them as your children. They are really outstanding students. They have exemplified everything we would want in a student at Hadley Elementary School. So I can't wait to hear and see and read about them in the paper. And that 2024 seems like a long way away. I can remember when my boys were born and I said, 2010, that's like the next century. And it came and went in the blink of an eye. And now they're young adults. And so please cherish every moment with them, because if you think that these last 7 years have gone by quickly, the next 7 will go by that much faster. So enjoy them. And students, I really do commend you and look forward to reading and hearing about all the great things that you'll be doing. But with no further said at the moment, let's enjoy the rest of the evening, and they've got lots of different memories to share in addition to the ones that they already did through their song. So thank you for sharing your students with us. It has been a pleasure, and I know I speak for all the staff. And so we'll enjoy the rest of the evening and this celebration. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us on this wonderful day. Tonight, we have a special guest with us. This man helps us in our everyday school life. He is very helpful by cleaning our cafe and our classrooms. He really makes our school a better place and a learning atmosphere. Please welcome to the stage an unsung hero, Arkansonian Mr. Sheehan.
Decisions to lead you up to the sixth grade class. Now you're in the space age, which I believe is you. You're shooting for the stars. You're shooting for the big doors. The doors that will give you more opportunities. But have you noticed that when you come in this morning, in the morning to school, the doors out front here, you get off your bus, the doors are always wide open for you, with open arms. Well, those doors are called the doors of opportunity. When you pass down the aisle to go to your classroom, through the doors of opportunity, you run into another door. Some of the doors you don't like, a little locker room door, but that's okay, but it keeps your educational material. There's another door you walk into, and that I call the doors of knowledge. And on the other side of that door is the teachers with the knowledge and how to pass on their knowledge to you. You read a book, you look at a computer, but they're the ones that will teach you how to extract the knowledge from that, bring it into you so that you can look for a better future. So as you progress, you'll notice that they give you all this hard work, and you're working to study, and so forth and so on. And it's like a car that goes down the highway, and it goes so fast, and then pretty soon it stops in the middle of the road and runs out of gas. Well, that's why we have a cafeteria. So after you work so hard, they give you a break, you come up, and you have a cafeteria staff who energizes you so you can go back and you can learn and you can study harder. So it all takes like a team effort. And I consider the school as a community within a community. So everyone benefits. And the greatest asset to the parents of your children is your education. And the greatest asset to the community is how you progress and how you grow up and how much knowledge you gather. That's what will sustain the communities in the future, because you will be the future teachers. And it's a little hard for me to talk. I didn't know what to talk about today because I'm not used to talking a lot. But I will say that after going through these doors out here, the welcoming doors, and you gain the knowledge that you gain, I tried to put us together and come up with a solution as to putting the knowledge together along with everything else that you're dealing with, and I happen to realize that I'm still learning too. You never stop learning. Every day that goes by, since I've been in this school, I've also been taught, and I'm still learning. And I guess what really got me is that recently they had a show here, a literacy program, where they read to the children, and I thought it was, all of a sudden I got a new lesson right there. Because you have a superintendent and principal who read the books of the three little kids. And I'd say, oh, that's fine, they read it to all these little children. But I put it in a different context. I realized that as they read that story, it showed what it means when you have a strong foundation. And your education that you're receiving now is building that foundation. And as you build that foundation, as you move on to the next level, your foundation will grow stronger and stronger. And pretty soon, when you get into this world, and this world is not an easy world, as you grow up and you enter into having to go out and work, pay your bills, deal with all the finances and so forth, you'll find out. But that foundation that you're building now will sustain you through all of that, and you will weather all of those storms. Take my word for it. So, I would just, most of all, like to thank the graduating class. You've done me a great honor, and you've opened the door for me. And I think one thing I'd like to say, that along with your learning, what may make you feel good, you also need something that makes you feel like with a little pride and proud. I'd like to be proud. So when you're out and about, and you happen to see somebody walking through pain, and you push their wheelchair, and you're going through a door, it will make you feel very proud, and you'll feel good about yourself. You go open a door for someone else, because people are opening doors for you, and you'll feel very proud about it. It will strengthen your foundation. And before I go, I've noticed that sometimes here in the lunchroom, you have a, what do they call it, a little tip where someone recites a quote and you're supposed to get an answer. Well, I have one for you, but I'm not going to give you the answer. I'm going to give this to you, and then tomorrow, during the lunch time, you can come in and receive the answer. Now, if you know the answer, there'll be many answers. If you know the answer, don't tell anybody. Just give it to yourself. You're not going to enjoy yourself. That's why I say it to the end. So, I invited some friends of mine to come to your party. They're coming up the ramp now. See, I got to bear with me. I'm old. And I can't see them. Any of you can hear. I'm going to have them walk across in front of here. And as they're walking across, I'm going to describe them to you. Okay? Listen very carefully, because the words I'm saying, you have to know. You have to listen to every word. You ready? Okay, come on. Here you go. How about you watch? Here we go. You're all walking in the line, right across in front of you, and you're going to walk out the back door. There's two ducks walking in front of the duck. There are two ducks walking in back of the duck. There's a duck walking in the middle. Now, how many ducks? Have a wonderful night.
Organizations in our town. The Lions Club has presented dictionaries to Hadley sixth graders for years. We thank them for continuing this tradition. At this time, Dr. Wickman will announce our names as we come up to get a dictionary from Mr. John Miller and Mr. George Urge of the Lions Club.
here this evening to honor and recognize the sixth grade graduating class of Hadley Elementary School. I'm here to represent the Hadley Lions Club and to offer our congratulations as well, and to give to each student a dictionary to remind them that a lot more learning still has to take place. Thank you.
Cassidy Reed Bishop.
our dual karma. Dia Dishant Patel. Signa Poppy Tapure Rogers Patno. Jackson Lawrence Paul.
Oh.
you're doing better guessing than I was, but what adorable babies. And remember what I said at the beginning, how quickly those years went, how quickly those 12 and 13 years went by? Well, memory lane. So, it is a special honor to be able to send the class of 2024 off with a few closing remarks. And I will be brief, because I can see them taking the lids off those delicious desserts over there. And I know that my remarks are the only thing preventing us from getting to that buffet. So at this point, I would like to talk to the sixth grade students. Even though, I've only known you for 2 years, I know that I speak not only for myself, but for the entire staff when I say that you will be missed here at Hadley Elementary School. I think I've been hearing that in the teacher's room, like, for months. But anyway, you've made us proud in so many ways. Not only have you accomplished many things academically, but you've been excellent role models for the younger students. You have embraced and lived our Hawks behavior. You've been honest. You've more or less always tried your best. You've been willing to help others. You've been kind and you've been safe. So if you continue to embrace and live by those Hawks behaviors, I have no doubts that you will be successful in life. This year I had the pleasure of going on 2 field trips with you. By the way, the only class I wanted to go on a field trip with. I knew that you could really handle it, but also I do have to get on a bus and get bus sick, which I do every time. So, but once again, you made your teachers and me very proud of the way you conducted yourself on these trips. The most memorable outing for me was going to the movie Wonder. That was a very, very powerful movie. About the way we treat other people. There is a quote in the book and in the movie of which I'd like to restate here. It's by Henry Ward Beecher. Greatness lies not in being strong, but in the right using of strength. He is the greatest whose strength carries up the most hearts. I just want to read that last part again. He is the greatest whose strength carries up the most hearts. As you go forward in your education and in your life, I am confident you will have the strength and kindness to carry up many hearts. And in doing so, you'll be very successful and make many contributions to the world. Best wishes to you, and thank you for many wonderful memories.
We gave them a lot of special gifts, and they're going to take that into the future. We're all very grateful, so thank you all to the teachers and all of the staff. And finally, to the guests of the night, the class of 2024. Please remember the lessons that you've learned here at Hadley Elementary School. And take these lessons with you to Hopkins, or wherever you go after this, and wherever you go after that. Good luck, work hard, have fun, and always remember to be good to each other. We are all very proud of you. Congratulations. Now go ahead and have a snack. Enjoy.